of people think that Canva is just a design software that you can get on the internet for free, when actually there's a ton of apps that you get access to even if you're just on the free plan. So I'm going to walk you through five pretty cool ones that maybe you haven't even heard of yet. So once you log in to your dashboard, you're going to see any designs that you have created. These are some of mine, but then you can also go over here over to the sidebar and you're going to see Discover Apps. Now that's where you're going to click and it's going to open up the land of opportunity for you. So you're going to see some of the trending apps inside of Canva, the ones that are really popular right now, or even some newer ones if you scroll down just a little bit. Now what you're going to do first is you're going to click right here where it says All Apps. That's going to give you the whole rundown of all of the apps available right now, and they're always testing new ones. So if you can see up here, this is the, I don't know, the featured one, and it's really cool. I talked about this one in the previous video, which I'll link, but you can write in text and it'll convert it to an image right inside of Canva. So I think that's pretty cool. So you're in the All Apps section, and the first one we're going to talk about is the Character Builder. Now, this is going to be for my friends out there who are interested in creating like children's books or really any kind of book or graphic where you kind of want to customize the character. So let's dive into the first one. The first one's going to be Character Builder. Now, this is especially for people who are thinking about writing a children's book. You can actually write your entire children's book in Canva. So you're going to open up the Character Builder and say use in new design, which of course you can use it in the design that you've already created. But for this purpose, we're going to open up a brand new sheet. So I just did the Instagram square. That's like my go-to. And once we get in here, you're going to see over here on the left, all the different ways that you can customize your unique character. So it's going to open up ways that you can have their hair, how you want them to dress, their body type, how you want them to be, like, do you want them to be standing, sitting, running? What do you want them to do? So you're just going to click and you can customize the hair, the skin tone, anything you want. And maybe you say, oh no, I'm scared, or yeah, I'm super happy. No, I'm kind of mad. You can do it however you want. And again, here's the different body styles that you can use as well. So once you have this, let's say you did want to go ahead and, you know, make a background for your character, you can absolutely do that. So I just double clicked on my character, which allows me to move them all around, and I can adjust the size if I want to. And then if we want to get real fancy, which of course we do, we're going to go over here to elements, and this is where we get to start having some fun. So we can say, I'm just going to say cartoon background, and you'll be able to see all these different things that you can do. So like, let's put, and again, this is just on the free plan. You can see these little crowns here, that's on the pro plan. And I'm just going to do this, position that background to the back, and there, look at that. He's just hanging out, and then we can adjust the colors as well. So this is something that you can have fun with. And like I said, you can build out your entire children's book if you want to, and just go ahead and put the words in there or put the words right down here and just add page after page. All right. Now, the second one that we're going to talk about is the Draw app, which is really interesting because you can actually draw, sketch, do whatever you want inside of this app. And it's right here. It says draw, and it's in beta form right now, which is cool. And we're going to, I'm just going to show you what this looks like. I'm going to open up that Instagram square again. We're going to go over here. And then, so for example, I did write a children's book, and I have a sketch app that I use on my iPad. I could have, if I wanted to, just done the whole sketches for my Illustrator right here in Canva. I think they did. They must have just rolled this one out. I don't know. But we're going to open it here on the sidebar. See, it says draw. It's in beta form right now, but you have your pen, your marker, your glow pen, and your highlighter. So you can think, you know, just all the different ways that you could use this. I really like the glow pen. So let's have some fun with that. And we can do all of our sketching here. Like, let's say we have a document and we need to underline some stuff, or maybe we did a social media post, but we want our unique arrow. We're gonna point to something really interesting. Maybe we even do our signature all fancy. That's not my signature, but you get the idea. You can have so much fun just sketching inside of Canva. Now, the third one we're going to talk about is the QR code generator. And the reason I like talking about this one is because, especially for those of you who maybe you do a lot of social media posting, or maybe you make brochures or do a lot of marketing or advertising of the thing that you sell, these are pretty handy to create. And you can create a QR code for literally anything. You could have the QR code go to your website. You could have it go to your social media. It's totally up to you, but I'm going to walk you through how to actually get that set up. Now, this is an app that you use through Canva, but you are going to need to create a QR account through the QR software. But Canva directs you, tells you how to do it. You get 10 free QR codes when you do this. So it says add QR code to your design. You're going to go down here and say use, and this is where they're going to walk you through. If you don't have your account set up, it's going to say set up your account. And if you do, this is the next step. So let's say I just want a QR code for the back of my book that I just made, let's say, and we want people to, you know, once they point their phone at that QR code, I want it to open up my website. So in the URL section, we're going to say, we're going to do that. That was kind of fancy. We're going to do that. And then we're going to say, you can go here to customize if you want to make it like a different color. You can do that. Let's do pink. Pink is always the right color. And then if you want to make it bigger or smaller, totally up to you how you want it to look. We're going to say generate QR code, and it's going to pop it right over here. And again, you can put this on any design. Let's say you made a cover of a magazine. Let's say you made a cover of your book, or you just want it for social media posts. It's going to, you can add that QR code to anything, and you can have it direct to anywhere, which is awesome. Now, the next one we're going to talk about is the YouTube button. So this says you can add a YouTube video into any of your designs. So what if we added it into an existing design? We're going to go into this where it says use an existing design, and we're going to see, I don't know where I want to put it. We'll just put it in some random design that I made. I don't know. We'll do this one. That's fine. And what you're going to do once this pops up is you're going to see over here on the sidebar, it's going to give you a search bar. In that search bar, you can actually search for pretty much any YouTube video out there. So that's me. And let's say I want to do like a YouTube video right here. And let's say we're going to share this maybe on Facebook. I don't know. So here's that search bar that I just mentioned. And we're going to go up here and we're going to say, this is my YouTube handle, and you can see some of my videos popping up here that I can add over here into my design. Now, they're going to give you some options for videos maybe that are trending right now if you wanted to add those into your design. Gosh, I couldn't remember what that was called. So let's say I do this. It's going to actually add that video onto my design, and then I can customize. How big do I want it? How small do I want it? It's totally up to me. And then when people see your design, they can actually click on here and it'll open up another window onto your YouTube channel. How fun is that? Woohoo! Now, the next one I'm going to show you, I always have a hard time finding it. So I'm just going to go to this little search bar right here and type in Pixton. And what this is going to do, this is for all of you out there who are thinking about creating your own comic books. It's actually going to bring up a bunch of characters that you can use and customize into your comic books. So once it pops up, Pixton, right here, you're going to click on that. You're going to say use a new design, or if you want an existing one, and it's going to give you characters kind of like this. And so again, if you're wanting to create a comic book or, you know, just some fun social media posts that have cartoon characters in it, this is an easy way to do it. So they're going to give you a lot of options over here on the left as far as different characters that you can use. All different, look, astronauts, doctors, all different types of characters. And you can just scroll through and see what suits you and which one would work best for you and for creating your comic book. Now, just for kicks, if I go over to Canva, let's see. I haven't even tested this, but we're going to try and see if they have a comic book like layout. They do. So over here, create a design. We're going to say comic strip. Look at this. When you open up comic strip, let's see what it looks like. So when you open up the comic strip designs, look at all of these templates that you have to choose from. All of these different comic templates. So we can just say this and add it in, change the colors if we want to. How fun is that? So if we did this, Okay, let's say you're here and you're like, oh, cool. I added, my comic strip design, but how do I get the characters in there without going to a different page? You're going to come right down here where it says apps. Click on apps, and then you can search for that Canva app right here, which was Pixton. It's going to be right there, and it's going to pull up all of those characters for you. This is so cool. So we can add in our characters. So we can add in all of our little characters, start building out that storyboard of our comic strip. And this is just a super creative and awesome feature that Canva has. So I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know in the comments which one you liked the best, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.